Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. And anyway, I'm just trying to show some pictures, go through the pictures of the Vacation Bible School. We just finished up. I posted some videos of the kids singing and stuff on and me talking to them on YouTube, and then now this, and then I put some of the couple of the pictures on Facebook. And these are the kids getting their awards. Each kid got a different award. Of course, they all got ribbons. That's my wife that's there, Jessa. Just FYI, that's a neighbor lady that lives in a hut across the street, and she always comes over and eats with us whenever we go to the orphanage, whenever we have some special occasion. She's got about 3 kids. So all of these kids are the orphans. Had so many orphans, we couldn't really have hardly any of the, before we've been having a Vacation Bible School with all the neighborhood kids too, but we just got so many orphans, and this is actually my wife's niece is there too. She's got a couple of nieces. They're there, and then the rest are all the orphans. One of the new orphans. This is surprising because I prayed with some of the new orphans, a lot of the new orphans, and I even got a word from the Lord. A couple of the kids had chicken pox. They weren't able to be there. So this is that's some of our original orphans there, the one which is on there. There's one of our original orphans too, John Ray. So these are all the orphans. Like I said, this is the new house mom there. I'm just showing all these pictures and keep going. That's what I was talking to them. I have a video of me doing that. Then I prayed with all the new orphans, and surprisingly I got a word from the Lord for several of them, which was really important. And I would say that I had personal words for them, but the main thing, and a word for the house moms and dads of how to deal with each one. So it was wisdom from the Lord, words of wisdom from the Lord, words of knowledge from the Lord for the children, words of wisdom for the house parents. And then the Lord really put it on me, and this is the point, is that the orphans are very precious to the Lord. Even as the Bible tells us in the book of James, that perfect religion is keeping ourselves spotless from the world and ministering, you know, and helping widows and orphans. So the Lord really reminded me, and I told the house moms and house dads that taking care of these orphans is really a big deal with the Lord. It's not a small thing, and it's not just a routine, casual thing. It's a very important thing. This is important as anything else, like doing evangelism, being a pastor of a church or whatever. Any of those kind of things that you might think of that might seem, you know, are important to God, this is also very important. See, there I am getting a word. The Lord started speaking to me, and then my wife is translating. Jessa is translating for me to the kids, and I got a word for several of them. And there's the first house mom. As you can see, these kids have never, the new orphans have never been prayed for. Now, I mean, they've been at the orphanage for a few weeks, some of them been there for a couple of months. So I don't know if anyone's laid hands on them besides me. I think the house mom and them have been teaching them to pray, but maybe not laying hands on them. So that's the first time maybe they experienced the Holy Spirit, experienced being prayed for. There's the youngest boy there, I guess, Michael. Remember the woman that's a widow? If you're in the Facebook group, we have a widow woman. As the Bible says, take care of widows and orphans. We have a widow woman with 2 small children. That's her daughter, Joy. The boy is Michael. And by the grace of God, one of these days in the future, she will be able to be a house mom. So right now, we're helping her, letting her kids be part of the orphanage, letting her, you know, help there, wash the dishes, etc., laundry and things like that. And then later on, by the grace of God, that widow sister, she's a convert of mine from 2008 maybe, or 2009, and I water baptized her and her husband there. And then she, of course, her family's Muslim, and they started persecuting her, and they call her Anga is her name. Anyway, her family was persecuting her. They're all Muslims, and then that's why we let her move to the orphanage. Her family was trying to force her to convert her children to Islam and all this. Here's the kids. We had spaghetti and different things for them that day. We had some Cokes and Sprites and the old glass bottles. That's what they have in the Philippines. And There's the first, the house dad of the first house, Riniel. He's opening these bottles up with a knife. This is the girl who I had a video of, the girl that she was one of my converts too from 2006. Mm-hmm. Her older brother was healed through prayer. When I prayed with him, the Lord healed him. And she is the youngest of nine kids. Her mother and father have no money to even feed her, so she's at the orphanage now. She's only been to like the second or third grade or whatever she said on the video that I posted about the healing miracle. There they got a picture of us in the light. That's me and her. And they call her Tata is her nickname. She's 14 years old. She's from a really remote place. She's really a native. All Filipinos are natives, but some of the tribes have been living in, you know, Western culture for generations, and some are just new to Western culture. Okay, here's some of our turkeys. They built a roosting ladder for them to climb on to the coconut tree. That's why I just thought it'd be cool to take a picture of the turkeys. This is one of the new boys. His name is Gmar, and he is out there. His chore, all the children have chores, and what he does is wash out the pig stalls and give the pigs water. So I guess he's taking a bath at the same time. He's playing in the water. This is our well that we dug. It's like we had to go down about 70 feet or 80 feet to get good water. But we still have the municipal water also. This water is maybe not potable, so we're using it for the animals, the turkeys and the pigs and all that, using it to do laundry and whatnot. There's the turkeys again. I just thought it was cool. There's the car. Again, thanks to all the sponsors. They built a little shed over it, you know, and to keep the sun off of it. And there's the vehicle. The tires are, you know, this car was used, and one of the tires has really gone bad. We got the spare on there now. We need to buy new tires. The tires are pretty worn out, and they are, you know, I mean, that's part of buying a used car. You know, in the Philippines especially, the tires are wore out pretty much. So we got to buy four new tires. That's just, you know, we always have lots of projects. Anyone that feels led, please, we can never, it seems like it's just, you know, there's always something when you're talking all the orphans and the property and the vehicle now and, you know, everything you add that we need, like a vehicle. Then, of course, it's got maintenance, you know, the oil needs to be changed. In this case, we just got it. It needs tires. There's some of the chickens. I went up into our, what they call a bahakubo, which is it's a house on stilts that we built there to have for the kids can use it for occasion and then go underneath it. You can get in the shade underneath it. And I went up in there and took some pictures. There's the swing set that the second house dad, who is my sister-in-law's husband, Ramel, is a welder and a driver. He's our driver and he welds. He fabricated this from metal. I mean, he made the whole swing set and, you know, just got the raw materials and made it. And some other stuff too. So he's doing all that in the maintenance and whatnot at the orphanages. And now he's become the house dad of the second house. This is the second house, which is originally original house. As you guys know, we have not started construction yet for the to add what they call a dirty kitchen onto this house like the other house has. Because it's been the Holy Week, they call it here. We had the vacation Bible school, all of that, etc. Oh, there's one of our guard dogs. Those of you who follow Joshua's ministry, you know we had some people trying to break into our property there. And what we had to do was get some dogs, was one thing that we did. And that's the boxes. I'm trying to look at all these pictures. That's, excuse me, brothers and sisters, I guess I've got two copies. That's not what I wanted. I'm trying to show some more pictures here. This looks like a repeat. Somehow I've got two copies on there. Well, what can you do, brothers and sisters? This is the stuff that people have sent in the boxes. Some of the boxes stuff that people have sent. And Sister Pearlie put the people's names on there. You know, lots of people, you know, don't necessarily want their names on there. Some do. You know, it's all good. That's why I'm going through it kind of fast, in case someone might not have wanted their name to appear. I'm just going to keep going. This is one of our feeding programs. That's Sister Daisy, wife of Pastor Raul. This is one of their daughters. She's about 18, maybe, or 20. They're doing one of the feedings. She's telling them, of course, about the Lord. They're praying, and then they're going to eat. So I'm just going to keep showing slides. Anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, our feeding programs, this is just one of our feeding programs. I was thinking we have seven, but maybe it's eight or nine feeding programs that we do. We have so many, and some are in remote areas. Like I said, we don't even take pictures because the pastor's there in the middle of nowhere. There's no electricity, no running water, and, you know, the camera would probably get broken. They don't have a way to load them up, and it's just, you know, it's just too much. So we always have needs. We all have always have more kids that want to eat more, that need our help, you know, and just can't get enough help. Anything that anybody feels led to do, you know, I'm just putting this out there. Like I said, our immediate need for the orphanage is the tires. We're going to start construction next week on the old orphanage and the new orphanage. We're going to add three bathrooms, two for the first orphanage, one more bathroom for the new orphanage, and then there'll be one, actually it's a, two bedrooms for the new one, and one bedroom for the old, and then a, what they call a dirty kitchen, an outside kitchen where it's like a, with an oven and all this outside the house for the new orphanage, the old house. As those of you who have been following me, you know that we have the original house on the property that just now became the new orphanage, and the new house, which was built a year and a half ago, or 2 years ago, a year and a half ago, is the old orphanage. Here they are, they're getting ready. This is called Benignit. And this is actually a mix of these. There's bananas that you can cook, kind of like a plantain, but they have 100 different kinds of bananas in the Philippines. Mixed with the heart of the palm. It's got jackfruit, something called jackfruit. Lots of different fruits and stuff in there. It's really delicious. As a matter of fact, it's probably my favorite Filipino food. But usually it's like what people eat at Christmas and stuff like that. I guess it's pretty colorful. But I love that benignit. It's probably my favorite Filipino food. And that's just another one of our new feedings there that I wanted to show you, and I will keep pushing through. As I put this on Facebook, when I was driving back from the orphanage a couple of weeks ago, when we got the van, I think it was, or no, we made the plans for the construction. This is typical what you see driving down the road. These people are trying to hitch a ride to the city of Davao. And you'll see trucks like this everywhere. People from the local village, somebody in the village is a truck driver for some rich businessman, you know, who owns a truck, who lives in the city, and he hauls loads of coconuts in it or whatever. And then if it's empty when they're going back, people just hitch a ride, you know. And that's just daily life in the Philippines. I just showed that for illustration. Here's the orphans that they have, like a little fair in the city of Digos, and we took them there. When we first got the van, let them go all over the place. I wanted to show that there's this is not all the orphans. This is a big batch of them. There they are. They got cotton candy and all that stuff. So many children to see. Here's the new. This is the new house, mom and dad. I've showed this on Facebook. And this is their first three orphans. They've got five now. That's Mary or Maria, and Ramel. And this is the old house. Like I say, we're going to add a kitchen, a dirty kitchen onto it, onto the side of it, right where they're standing at. As a matter of fact, we're going to make a dirty kitchen off the house, a 16 by 16 room. It's like with a table and chairs and all that, and an oven because it's going to be really hot, a wood stove, really, like we got at the other house. And then we're going to add a double right beside it, or over in this area. I'm backwards here. Anyway, we're going to put a 16 by 16 room, and then put a wooden wall in the middle of that cement room, and then make two 8 by 8 bedrooms, one for boys and one for girls. And I mean, that's about where we are with our budget. Of course, if our budget was more, we're going to make it bigger. I mean, you know, it's up to the Lord. I ask you guys to pray about it. You know, that the Lord, we know the Lord will provide. He's been providing for Joshua's ministry. Yeah, that's the house. We're going to build the dirty kitchen here, and then the bedrooms over in this area. And we were going to build up this way toward the road, but they may widen the road one day, so we're not going to do that. Time's up on this video. God bless you guys. Love you guys. I'll do some more prayer for people with words here.